Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
In this video, we are going to discuss about master-slave flip-flop. In our previous video, we have discussed about race around condition that whenever J is equals to 1 and K is equals to 1 and clock is at a high stage, we are facing a problem of racing. And we also discussed one more thing, that there is a difference between racing and toggling. But toggling is what we can say, that if my output is changing continuously but in a controlled way, that particular phenomena is called as toggling. But if our output is changing continuously in uncontrolled manner, it is not in a controlled manner, then that particular occurrence is called as racing. In order to overcome from the problem of race around condition, we already discussed that there are two ways by which I can overcome from this problem. One was edge triggering and second one was master-slave flip-flop. Now in this video, we will discuss master-slave flip-flop. First of all, let us discuss again that how this race around condition is occurred. The first condition for the racing output is that when J and K are both equals to 0 and if the clock pulse is high, or I can say that if the width of clock pulse is greater than 1, propagation delay of flip-flop, then in this case we always face this problem of race around condition. In order to overcome from this problem, we already discussed one way, that if we are using edge triggering, by using edge triggering we can overcome from the problem of race around condition. In this video, we will discuss about the master-slave flip-flop. Let me write it down. Master-slave flip-flop. Basically, there is nothing new. Every time we are using our basic element of flip-flop. Now, instead of using one stage of flip-flop, I'll use another stage. I'll connect one flip-flop with the another one, and then by combining two flip-flops, we can overcome from the problem of race around. Let me show the circuit first, then we will discuss that how we can overcome from the problem of race around condition. As we can see on the screen, that this is nothing but the JK flip-flop. This first one is JK flip-flop. Let us say that it is our stage 1. We have to add one more stage. Let's say it is stage 2. In order to differentiate between the two stages, what I am doing, that I am calling it by a master. So this is just a name, master, for the first flip-flop, that is for stage 1. Master, let me write it down here. And this is name for the stage 2, which is slave. So first of all, what we need to understand is that we will not get confused by these names. These are just names. That's it. There is no meaning for this master and slave. These are just a name which I am giving to the stage 1 and stage 2 so that we can differentiate it. So master, and first one is master, second one is slave. In this first one, this is my JK flip-flop, and second one is also JK flip-flop. There is just one change, that if let's say this is our clock, let me rub this unused marking, then we can discuss it further. So this is our clock and this is also clock. The output of the stage 1 is connected with the input of stage 2, and the clock of the first stage and stage 2 both are connected, but the clock for the stage 2 is connected in a complemented way. This is one of the most important point for the master flip-flop. This is how we can define the whole operation of the master slave flip-flop, that our stage 1 and stage 2 both are depending on the clock. Now our operation is fully depending on the clock. Stage 1 and stage 2 both will be operational or not, it will be depend on the clock. Let's say I'm saying that I'm applying a clock and clock is equals to 1. If clock is equals to 1, and let's say here this set, let's say this is 1 reset, so we are saying this is 0, so 1 0, and my clock is also 1, and if this is 1, then this will come here and this will be equals to 0 because of this NOT gate. If I'm saying that my clock is at a stage 1 for the master flip-flop, what we always understand by this thing, by this, our circuit will understand that my power is on, so now I have to perform my operation. So I can say that master is in operational form. This is what I can clear from the giving input. Now, if my clock is 0, it means that slave is not operational. Our slave is not operational. So, if we are saying that, let's say our previous output is 0 and 1. So, as this is the feedback for the input here, this is acting as, this is the feedback circuit here, this one is the feedback circuit, this green one, and this one will come here, so 1, and similarly the 0 will come here, so 0. Now at J we have 3 inputs, which is equals to 1, 1 and 1. So if this is 1, I can say that, and here this is 1, this is 0, and this is also this one at a 0 stage. Basically, what we can understand from this point, that if J is equals to 1 and K is equals to 1, I'll get 1 and 0 here. If my slave is not in an operational state, it is not in an operational state, what our circuit will understand by this thing is that if 1 and 0 are applying but my clock is at a low stage, it means that it is not a operational stage, so there will be no change in the output, it will just pass them on. Here I'll get 1 and here I'll get 0. There will be no change in my output because of the slave flip-flop if clock is at a low stage. So previously our output was 0, now it is 1. So I can say that there is a toggle in my output. We are getting toggling output, and there is no changing in the output continuously. It is not changing from 1 to 0, 0 to 1. It is changing only when I am applying my clock pulse. Let me discuss this point in a detailed manner once we understand the circuit diagram and the timing diagram for the master slave flip-flop, then we can easily understand this point also. For this moment, what we need to understand is that if my clock is at a one stage, if clock is at a, let me rub it down. So for this moment, what we need to understand is that if clock is at a one, only master will be in an operational stage. Suppose my clock is zero for a stage one. Here it will be in a one stage. Now master will be in not operational stage. And slave will be in operational stage. It means that one will be perform its operation and another one will just pass on its output. Let us first discuss the timing diagram, then we will again come back to this point. Let me read the point first, then we will proceed it towards the discussion. Working of a master slave flip flop. When the clock pulse goes to 1, the slave is isolated. J and K may affect the state of a system. This is what we discussed, that when this clock is goes to 1, our slave is isolated. It means that slave is in a non-operational state. It will not perform any operation even if I'm applying input. It will not perform any operation. It will not hold. It will not reset. It will not set. It will not toggle. He will just understand one thing, that whatever input is applying at its terminal, it had just to pass on. There will be no operation performed by him. J and K may affect the state of the system. The slave flip-flop is isolated until the clock is zero, and when the CP goes to zero, it means that clock pulse goes to zero, the information is passed from the master flip-flop to the slave and the output is obtained. This is what we have discussed earlier. Again, the master flip-flop, if it is a positive level triggered and the slave flip-flop is negative level triggered, so the master responds before the slave. What do we understand by this point is that if my master flip-flop and the power of slave is getting on by applying zero. So if I'm saying that master is in an operational stage, I can say that it is in a positive level triggering. Let me write down this point. We have two boxes. First one is master, second one is slave. I am saying that both are connected to each other. Both are connected to each other. But both are not in an on stage at the same time. If master is working, slave will not work. He is not in a operational stage. So if we are saying that this is in a on stage whenever we are applying one, so that stage is called as positive level triggered, and this is getting on . It is also getting on by one, but as it is at a zero stage, because both the clock are connected to each other in a complemented way. The clock for each flip-flop, if this is the clock, then we are using NOT gate. That's why I'm saying that if it is at a one stage, then it will be at a zero stage. So this is a positive level triggered and this is at a negative level. These are just names for one and zero. So that I can differentiate. Whenever I'm saying that I'm applying positive level triggering, what I will understand or what we will understand by this point, that master is in a working stage. If I'm saying that I'm applying low level triggering, it means that slave is at a zero stage. It is not in a operational stage. So let us look at the third point. If j is equals to 0 and k is equals to 1, that is what we discussed, that if high Q output of the master goes to the K input of the slave and the clock forces the slave to reset and thus the slave copies the master, that if master is at an operational stage and slave is in a not operational stage, then whatever output slave is getting from the master, master is giving it output slave, then slave will just copies the output. It will not perform any operation on my input. This is what we discussed in the working of the master-slave flip-flop, that first of all, always master and slave, we have two boxes. In a very simple manner, what we can understand by this point is that we have two boxes. One is called as master and second one is called as slave. Master is in on stage, then slave will not be in a on stage. Master will produce some output, slave will just copy that output and giving us a output which is in a toggle stage. If master is in not an operational stage, then slave will be in an operational stage, slave will some produce output and giving us the output. So there will be no interference of slave and master in their each particular operation. Let us look at the timing diagram for the master and slave, and we can prove this point that there is no condition for the race around. These are the same points which I already discussed, that if j is equals to 1 and k is equals to 0, still my output is high, master goes to the j input and of the slave, negative transition of the clock sets the slave copying the master. Still we are repeating the same point that we discussed earlier. If j and k both are equals to 1, it toggles on the positive transition of the clock, thus the slave toggles on the negative transition of the clock. So the second point is, if j and k both are equals to 1, it means that master and slave both will understand that every time they have to toggle. But as we already discussed, that they are actually working on the basis of a clock. So if clock is changing, if clock is 1, master will work. If clock is 1 for the slave, then slave will work. So slave toggles on the negative transition of the clock. It means that negative transition of the clock, if this is my master and this is my slave, I'm just taking the clock pulses so that I can explain this point. If this is our clock, now if this point, negative transition of the clock, it means that for the master this is slave, and for the master if my clock is at a zero stage, then it will be at a one stage for the slave. So, and J and K both are at 1, and here it is. Now if my master is at a zero stage, it means that it is not in an operational stage, it will just copies the output. So again at slave, so I can say that at slave it is in a working stage. If 1 is applying, it will just toggle the output. Basically it will give us the output which is in a toggling mode. This is what we can understand from this term, negative transition of the clock, that now slave is in a operational stage. Last point, if J and K both are equals to 0, then flip-flop is disabled and Q remains unchanged. Of course, we know that from the truth table of JK flip-flop, that if my inputs are at 0, there will be no change in the output. So I can say that my Q remains unchanged. Q is nothing but the output. Now let us look at the clock timing diagram. Timing diagram of the master flip-flop. Now we will try to understand the working of the master-slave flip-flop with the help of a timing diagram, that how we can get the output. I'm using a different color pen so that we can understand the working. let's say this is the output here. Please look at the screen that this is the output for master. And this is the output for slave. Now, whenever I am applying 1 at the master, it will be in an operational state. Let me write down it here. M is equals to 1 and slave will be in an OR state when we are applying negative transition. So, negative transition, slave will be in a on state. So, let me write down 1 here. We will discuss this point in a next moment. First of all, let us discuss for the master slave. Master, let us talk about master. Now, if my clock is at a high stage and I'm applying j is equals to 1, k is equals to 1. We fixed our output at j is 1 and k is 1. It is in a toggle state. So if earlier it is 0, now it will be remain as 1. It is in a 1 stage when until or unless. So if my clock is at a high stage, we are getting 1. Now clock is at a 0 stage, the master will be in a working stage, but slave will be in a working stage. Here, if my clock is at a high stage, slave, and this is master, this is slave, Qman, this Qm stands for master, Qs stands for slave, then I can say that if this is 0, it will toggle, then I'll get 1. Master will give us an output of 1. As slave is in not an operational stage, I can say that it will just pass on the previous output. So this is 0 and this is 0. He will not toggle anything. Slave will not toggle anything. So our output, let's say this is our final output. This is our final output, which is 1. Now, again, my clock is 0. If my clock is 0, what master will understand, the clock is 0, then it will just pass on its, or I can say that it will copy its previous output. So it is 1, again it will be at 1. But when our clock is at a 0 stage, my slave will on. Because it will on with the negative transition. This is the negative transition. So slave will be in a working state, then it will toggle its output. So if previous output was 0, then it will be 1. Now again my output is 1. Again this clock is at a high stage. Master will be in a working state and slave will be in a non-working state. Then it will toggle, so it will be 0. But slave is not in a working state, so slave will copies its output, previous output. Still our output, this is our final output. This is for master, this is for slave, and this is our final output. Now I can say that here we are getting 1. Here we are getting 1. Now what I can say, now here it is 0. So now master will copy, again I'll get 0. Slave will toggle because it will be in a on state. So here it is 1, then it will be in a 0 state. I'm getting 0 here because master is at a 0 state and here it is also at a 0 state. So this is what I am getting. This is our final output, that if one is in on stage and another one is in non-working stage, it doesn't matter at all. This is our final output. In the final output, we will just look at the clock. This one, first one, let me give it as a first point, and this will be our second point, and this is our main concern, this final output. Now, whenever our clock, this is our zero, this was our previous output. J and K both are equals to 1. I applied clock, and when I applied clock at a high stage, my output is getting toggle. So I am getting 1. I am getting 1 till clock is again high. Then again it is 0. 0, 1, 0. It is changing its output every time whenever I am applying my clock. Whenever my clock is high, it is changing its output. There is no changing such that it is continuously changing. This is not a continuously changing stage. This is a stable stage. In this way, we overcome from the problem of race around condition, that now my output is not changing continuously, it is changing at a particular instant of time. Whenever clock is applying, my output is changing at that instant instead of changing every time. So we can say that we overcome from the problem of race around condition by using two flip-flops, that is master and slave flip-flop. Let me summarize our points, that when the clock pulse is high, the output of the master is high and remains high till the clock is low because the state is stored. Of course, the state has to be stored because our slave, it is not a working stage, it will not perform any operation. And that's why it will simply copy its previous stage. Similarly, if output of the master becomes low, it means that it is in a non-operational stage. And when the clock becomes high again and remains low until the clock high again. So it is not an issue that whoever is in on stage, who is in not on stage, we are just concentrate on our final output, that our final output is having a stable state, it is not changing continuously, which was our purpose, that we want to overcome from the problem of race around condition. Similarly, when the clock pulse is high and the master is operational but not the slave, thus the output of the slave remains low till the clock remains high. This is what we have discussed in our clock diagram. Again, I am just trying to repeat the points. And when the clock is low, the slave becomes operational, remains high until the clock again becomes low. Toggling takes place during the whole process since the output is changing once in a cycle. And this is our point of concern, that every time master is changing or slave is changing. But if we are concerning, or if we are concentrating on our final output, toggling is happening. This is what we wanted and this is what we are getting now, that toggling is happening in the whole process. It doesn't matter who is giving us toggling, master or slave. We are getting toggling from the whole system. And now, since the output is changing once in a cycle, it means that when, for example, this is, let's say this is capital T, this is one cycle. Now, my output is something like this. This is my output. When my clock is at a high, my output is toggled and now it will remain 1 until I'll apply next clock and then it toggles. 0, 1, 0. So I can say that this is at a high stage till 1 clock. This is what we meant by this point, that once in a cycle it will be equals to 1. This is what we wanted. This is how we can overcome from the problem of race around condition. This is how we can define the working of master slave flip flop, and we can also define again, or we can prove our point in master slave flip flop with the help of a Teigmann diagram, that how we can overcome from the problem of race around condition, how we can get a stable state instead of getting output which is changing every time. We are getting output for a single clock. This is how we can achieve by designing two flip-flops together in a certain way. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with eKida and subscribe to eKida.